This call is now being recorded.
Okay, so again, this would be another recorded discussion meeting. Okay, so I want anyone to tell me if anyone having any problem regarding this. So is there any problem with you, Sania, or anyone? Nikhil Patel, Bhumika. Okay, so we'll just continue with that. So I'll just share my screen. Is my screen visible to all of you? Just check whether my screen is visible to all of you or not.
It's visible, sir.
Okay. Fine. Now, what I'll show you is that So this is a refresher that what are these are graphs. Okay, these connections are called, anyone, what are these connections called? What are these connections called?
Links, sir.
No, when you have a graph, these connections are called elements. Okay. Now, this graph is divided into two parts, the tree and the co-tree. Got it. So this is a graph. Graph has elements. Now you divide the graph into two parts. This is just to remind you people. You see that graph is divided into two parts. This part is called the tree and this part is called the co-tree. What is a tree? Tree is the subgraph that connects all the nodes but has no closed loop. Okay. The link is the other part of the subgraph. So this is the co-tree. It is the other part of the subgraph, or it is the another subgraph that is obtained when tree is taken out of the graph. If you remove the tree, you'll be left with this part of the graph, right? Now, what are for this tree, what are these links, these lines called? Bhumika, I'll ask you. What are these lines called?
Links, sir.
No. These lines are called branches. For the tree, these lines are called branches. For co-tree, these lines are called links. Okay. So you can see here is that the branches are in this solid color lines and the links are in this dotted. I think this is visible to all of you. Okay. Now what happens is that when you include one of the link of the co-tree with the tree, will have a closed loop. Okay, so this is the formation. Next, we have talked about the primitive network, we have seen that this is the formation of different formation of primitive network. That means these branches, each and every branches or links can have this kind of a network, each and every branch. These are the primitive network. Now for this single line, the equations are formed like this. Okay, so if you have a series source and the impedance, the equation is something like this. And if you have a current source and parallel admittance, you will have equation something like this. Is these two equations understandable for all of you? These two equations. Bhumika, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Is these two equations understandable? Can you understand these two equations? This equation is this,
yes.
For this, this is this. So this is what, see, this is like you place this element in this link. You place this element in this link. So these are just the primitive network. This can be, this network can be on any part of this line, links or branches. Okay. Now for these small, this portions of this circuit, we have found out these equations. Now if you go on taking the equations for all the branches, you will come across a matrix something like this. I'll just show you. This is the matrix something like this. If this matrix is obtained, if all the links or all the branches have this kind of elements, that means a series resistance with an impedance. If every branch contains series resistance and impedance in this graph, now if we write the equations, you will come across this kind of an equation. That these are in capital, that means these are matrices. Okay. Similarly, the admittance matrix is obtained if all the branches are connected with current source and parallel admittance. This part. Current source and parallel admittance. Okay. So this, if you go on writing the matrix, you'll have this current source and parallel admittance. Okay. Now I'll ask someone. Vishwanath, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, imagine there is a circuit which has two nodes, okay, two nodes and one current source, whatever the circuit is, okay. In this condition, what would be the size of I, size of J, size of Y and size of V, matrix size of V? Others you also try to find out. It's a two node circuit.
Two cross two.
Which one is two, would be two cross two? I, what is the size of I? What is the size of J? What is the size of Y? And what is the size of V? Anyone else? Sania? Asomya, anyone who is there? It's just a discussion. I don't expect that you'll be giving the right answer, but it would be good for you to. It's a simple one. It's a two node circuit. Whatever the circuit is, it's a two node circuit. Then, if you write the circuit in terms of current and admittance and voltage, what would be the matrix size of I, J, Y, and V?
Sir, I 2 cross 2.
I 2 cross 2. No. You remember the circuit I gave you in the previous class? Wait, let me see. I hope this is visible to all of you. What did I do? Just forgive my drawing because this mouse and all. So hopefully you are getting this is the current source. Okay. This is also a current source. Okay. Let this one be 1 ampere, this one be 2 amperes. Okay, this is 3, this is 7, and this is 5. I don't know why I used this number, but whatever. How many nodes are there?
2 nodes.
2 nodes, right. So you have node number 1 and you have node number 2. Okay. Now, can you write the equation in terms of I, J and Y equal to YV, I plus J equal to YV, all of you? Just try it. Give me the final, by the way, how many equations will be there?
Two, sir.
Mm-hmm. There will be two equations. Vishwanath, are you getting it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. So I want you to give me the two equations that can be obtained from here. Just take a rough piece of paper and just I don't need you to solve this, just give me the equations that have been formed. Vishwanath, I'm waiting. Okay, fine, you just take this other resistance, no issues. Or rather you take these 3, 5, 7 as admittance, not impedance. Okay, just take it as admittance. You take it as admittance, so tell me what will happen.
Sir, 10.
अच्छा ठीक है, तुम इनपे ठीक है बोलो.
हाँ which is pen.
रुको रुको रे, pen. I'm not getting the pencil. Pen, whatever. हाँ, 10. 10, 10 what? Ten what?
For the size, 10 v1 minus 3 v2.
10 v1 minus
3 v2.
3 v2. Okay. Equal to
21.
Equal to 1. Okay.
21.
21. Okay. Just do me a favor. Consider these two be as all as admittances. I made a mistake. I told you, don't take it as a resistance. Then you won't be able to get it. What I am trying to say. Consider these two be as admittances. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Just consider these two admittances. The equation will be simpler. I want to show you something. That is the reason. Others also, please respond. I want all of you to solve this. Can you do it? Take these as admittances 3, 5, 3, 7 and 5. Okay. Bhumika, have you solved it? अच्छा 7. हाँ बोलो बोलो 7 क्या है?
10 v1 minus 7 v2
it's very difficult to write with the pen mouse on. Okay, 10 v1 minus 7 v2 equal to 1. Very good. Next one.
6 v2.
6 v2
minus 7 v1.
6 v2. 6 v2 minus 7 v1. 6 v2
equal to
equal to 2. 6 v2 minus 7 v1 equal to 2. How are you getting 6? This, how, this is 3, 5 and this is 7. How are you getting 6? Yes.
Minus 7 v1 12 v2
yes.
Equals to 2.
There you have made a problem mistake. Vishwanath, you just made a mistake. Whatever. So it will be not this. It is minus 7 V1 plus 12 V2 equal to 2. Okay. I think it Varsha, you answered this, right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me what did you understand from this? There's some clue is there. Why this 10? Why this 12? Why minus 7 here, also minus 7 here?
So, branch of admittances for the nodes, sir.
So, you see, from this previous class, this, the V1, this equation is for the node 1, right?
Yes, sir.
This equation is for node 2. So for node 1, we are talking about V1. So the coefficient of V1 should be the self-admittance, that is the sum of all admittance connected to V1. So how many admittance connected to V1? Two admittance are connected to V1, 7 and 3. So it will be 10, 7 plus 3, 10. Similarly, when you are considering the second equation, V2, okay, then it is the self-admittance of V2, 7 plus 5. 7 and 5 are connected to V2, so you will have 12. Now, what about in the first equation, which is, just understand, in the first equation, which is considering node 1, you have this V2. That means the coefficient is the connection of V1 to V2. What is the connection? 7. And since it is a connection, the formation will be minus. Are you getting it? The formation would be minus. So if I draw it in the matrix formation, 10 minus 7 minus 7 and 12. Okay, multiplied by V1, V2 equal to 1, 2. Got it? So from here, so why I want you to do all these, can you answer this? What would be the matrix of I, J, Y, and V for a circuit of 2 nodes?
So for I, it is, yes, 2 cross 1 matrix, sir, and J also, yeah, 2 cross 1, sir. And YV is a 2 cross 2 matrix.
And V is a 2 cross 1 matrix. Got it? Okay. So you understood it. So, bolo.
Sir, that equations I'm getting, sir, different.
You take a 7 and 3, 5, these are all as, take it as admittances. You took it as impedance.
Yes.
Great. So again, next part is I am using the same circuit. Can you tell me what would be the shape of the graph if I draw the circuit in terms of graph? If it is a graph, what is the shape of this graph? How will the graph be?
So V shape.
Yes, the graph would be, I'm just trying to rub this thing out. Wait one second. Okay, so the graph would be this, right? This is the V1 node, this is the V2 node, and this is the, okay, let's say who to pick. Anyone can meet, can you tell me, this is a graph. Now this graph can be divided into tree plus co-tree, right? How many branches do you will the tree will be, and how many branches will have will the co tree have?
So 3, 2.
No, it is 2 and 1. This would be a tree, and this would be a co tree. See, the tree should connect all the nodes. There are 3 nodes, but it should not have any closed loop. The code tree is the other part. That the code tree, this is a link for the code tree. If this is connected to here, you have this this loop is formed. Got it? Okay. Now we'll go to the next part. So we should have a bus frame of reference. What I have told you about is for a single small circuit. Okay. Now this only has 2 nodes. It's a very simple one. But in the we are talking about a power system. So there are millions of buses. Okay. So once you understand the basic concept, that you can then you can expand it to that thousands and millions of buses. Now for this we needed to have a bus frame of reference. That means you should have one bus to be the standard bus. Okay, so what we'll have, one of these buses like V1, V2. Now we are talking about nodes in terms of power system. These are buses. Okay, that means multiple lines and connected to the same point. So one bus, you will take it as a standard bus. Why? So that what you require is a linearly independent equation. We do not require multiple equations, okay, of the same type, multiple equations of the same type. We need the exact number of equations that are required to be solved. Now you have to calculate something called a bus incidence matrix. Okay, now the bus incidence matrix, just look at this. Wait a sec. This 1, 2, 3, 4, you think of this graph. Okay, imagine that we are giving the names of the voltage at this point as V1, V2, V3, V4. I want you people, those who have papers with you, just draw this graph in order to understand, because I'm going to reference this graph. So just keep this graph in mind, or you draw it by yourself. Okay, so you make this V1, this is V2, okay, V3, V4, and this is V0. So if I write like this, VB1, if I write it as V1, VB1 is for the voltage across the branch B1. What is the branch B1? Just draw this along with this. Just write these numbers. This is the branch 1. This is the branch 2, branch 3, branch 4. This is the link 5, link 6, link 7, link 8, and link 9. Those of you who have a pen and papers along with you, just draw this and number this, because that is required for your this reference. See, VB1, what is it is writing as VB1 is the voltage across the branch B1. Which is the branch B1? This is the branch B1. You see, this is the branch and this is 1. So this is branch B1. Okay, so what is the voltage across the branch B1? It is V1. Actually, it should be V1 minus V0, but V0 is 0. You consider that to be a reference. So branch V1 is nothing but V1. V1 is the voltage at every node. Okay. B2 is V2. B3 is V3. B4 is V4. Okay, so this is simple. Branch B1, the voltage across the branch B1 is V1. Voltage across the branch B2 is V2. Voltage across the branch B3 is V3 and B4 is V4. Now tell me, what is the voltage across link 5?
V3
minus V4 is link 5. So voltage across link 5, you see VL5 is V3 minus V4. Okay, Raju, you are there. I've seen you, Raju Angri. Raju, are you there? Vishwanath, you are there? Vishwanath?
Yes, sir.
You tell me the voltage across the other links. Voltage across link 8. Voltage across link 8. Voltage across link 8, what would be the voltage in terms of voltage in the nodes?
Sir, V2 minus V4.
V4 minus V2. You see the current direction, I mean the arrow direction is from 4 to 2.
4 to 2, sir.
Yes, so it will V4 minus V4. So see, L8 is V4 minus V2.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so all these matrices are circuit, these are drawn. These are written. Okay, thank you. Now see, one more point is that these arrows which has been shown here, these arrows, you might say, sir, how did they get the current? These are not current. These are just taken as orientation, as direction. It tells you which voltage is higher and which voltage is lower. But is it actually the case? May not be. You have taken it as a random, but you have to take some direction. If your assumption is wrong, you'll get a negative answer. That's it. But these directions, all this direction, branch one, it is directed downwards. These branch three directed downwards. Four, branch two directed downwards. These branch, the direction of branches are totally random. But whatever the random thing is, that you have to write this equation. Okay, now I think you have understood how to write this equation. Now if you, so on this equation, on the left hand side, it's the voltage across the links or branches, and on the right hand side of the equation, it is that same voltage of links and branches in terms of voltage across the nodes or voltage at the nodes. Okay, so after that, you will have this kind of an equation, that this would be a matrix of the voltage across the branches or links would be equal to sum matrix into voltage of into the matrix of voltage of the nodes. That matrix that is being multiplied here is called the bus incidence matrix. Okay. Again, I'm repeating. This V bus is the matrix formed by the voltage of the nodes. If you multiply with this A matrix with the V bus matrix, you will get a matrix of voltage across the links and the branches. Now you'll say, what is the use? The use you will see. This matrix A is called the bus incidence matrix. For in our case, when we are using it, one sec, using this kind of a graph, okay, how many branches and links are there in total? How many branches and links are there in total?
Nine.
And how many nodes are there? Four. Right? There are four nodes and nine links and branches. Now you see the matrix is that there will be four column and nine links, nine rows. The first four would be the rows of the branches. Next five will be the rows of the links. Okay. Now this is the end of this class, but it is my request that you form this bus incident matrix for this circuit. Okay. And in our PSA group, try to draw this circuit and form the bus incidence matrix, write it down and give me a screenshot. And whatever, you take a photograph and send it to me. It is for your own good, that's it. If you do not do it, it is fine, that is up to you. But for this circuit, keep this circuit handy with you, brother. We'll do these calculation, like once you get to know calculation with a small circuit, for a bigger circuit, it is just the same. Just it is your matrix size will be more. But to get the bus incidence matrix, so what I'll just explain how many links you'll get. You have one link and two branches. Okay, so can you tell me what would be the size of your bus incidence matrix? What would be the size of bus? अरे नहीं रे नहीं बोलो 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 फिर से think. See, for like go back here. You see four. There are four nodes, nine branches and links. So this was 9 × 4. What would be this?
3 × 2, sir.
3 × 2, exactly. So you have three elements, and two. It will be something like this. Your matrix will be something like this. A 3 × 2 matrix. I want you to find this bus incidence matrix. Okay, so this is your homework. Try it out by today. You can, this just a simple thing. You know, it will take 2 minutes to do it. Just
we have to assume the direction of the current, sir.
Yes, you just assume the direction of the current. Assume it. This is called an oriented graph. Okay, when you write, this is graph theory says that you just write the graph theory is basically it simplifies a much complex circuit it just selects the node and you just show the connection, which nodes and which nodes are connected. Now you draw your random, whatever you like, random direction. Now you, with that random direction, you form the matrix. Okay, it doesn't matter. If your assumption is wrong, you'll get a negative answer. That's it. Okay, so take your whatever you direction you want. Okay, you just try to find out the bus incident matrix for this circuit. Okay, once you do it, we'll do the later calculation, because these calculations would be difficult for you to understand. But if I want you to understand from this small circuit basis, that will be very easy. So then you'll say, "Acha, okay, so it is not that difficult. It is just simply written in a matrix format." You won't be able to get this directly because there is a small matrix derivations here. But once you get this circuit, it will be very easy. So please take a screenshot, or you draw this circuit and just give me the bus incidence matrix today or whatever, whenever you get the time. Okay, but do it. This is it's good for you. Okay, so this is the end of our session. Any issues you can tell me. I'm available 24/7. Just call me up, send me a message or whatever. Okay. So I'm stopping the sharing part, screen sharing. Okay. So anything else? You can leave this this chat, this meeting. Just those who have not written, just write your name and your registration number. I mean, you said USN number, and then just leave. Okay. Just write your name and registration number, and leave the meeting. Thank you.
Sir.